best find in my life? I guess for some people that would be like, duh, Angie, how come you never knew about this? But I had the wrong impression about it, so I never checked it. And when I checked it, I drooled, and honestly speaking, I'll never do any purchases anywhere else I don't need. I mean, wow. So it's about Vestiaire Collective, this beautiful, sustainable luxury eBay that gets your things authenticated to make sure that they fit. So far, I've purchased from them quite a couple of things. I created an account and I put some stuff. If you want to check the stuff I'm selling, I'll be more than happy for someone of you guys to have it than someone else. So I'm gonna link my account down there so that you can check it. And for me, I honestly, whenever I need something, the first place I go to is Vestiaire Collective. Buying secondhand became a big deal for me. I only now buy secondhand. I'm going to show you around some of the things I bought secondhand, not necessarily only from Vestiaire Collective. However, Vestiaire Collective made me buy last month 8 items, which is a great number. It's been a while since I purchased that much, but I'm in midway, you know, after I've done my gastric sleeve surgery, I've lost a lot of weight, and all my clothes basically became not usable and wearable. So I had to buy things new, and I wanted to build a classic capsule. I made vision boards of what items I would want, and I wanted timeless pieces that would stay with me forever and forever more. I could even pass them down to my kids to invest in, and I got them with really dashing prices. I want to show you this. So I've been collecting all the tags that I got from Vestiaire Collective. You know, when you get something authenticated by them, they sent you the item with this tag, and it has on it, "We only sell things that we love." Those came in pristine condition. I guess I made another video about them. I keep shoe trees in them, as you can obviously see, but they came in such a good condition, and I wore them to many occasions. They're so comfortable. They're kitten heels. I am all about comfort, and these are super comfortable, you guys. I put shoe trees in them to make sure that I keep this leather part totally in a good condition. I got these from eBay, and they were originally purchased by someone from The Real Real, so they're double used, not one time. They used twice, and honestly, look at the sole for them being used twice and then used by me. Gorgeous shoes. Next item I got was from actually Facebook Marketplace. It is my GHD Gold straightener, and I got this for 60 euros. Which is exactly the price of a brown one or any brand that is, like, you know, not like the GHDs. These retail for 200 euros originally, and it was just secondhand. It comes with an enormous long cord. I got it from Facebook Marketplace. You can find cool stuff there, but you have to take care of them being like not original. Next is my beloved LV wool 100% black scarf. I don't know if you can see this. It's here it is. It's beautiful. It's my everyday scarf, and honestly speaking, let me show you the sign. This came in the box, and I have the box with me. I'm gonna show you the boxes and where I store the things in a bit, but beautiful. It's just beautiful. And I got this, I guess, also for a price of a regular scarf. So we start now with the items I got from Vestiaire Collective. I've showed you what I got from eBay. I've showed you what I've got from Marketplace as a secondhand. I even showed you things I got for free. It wasn't only the shoe trees that I got for free. I also got a TV in my room for free on that group. I got a lamp in my room for free. Water filter for free. So really, if you keep an eye on these places, you're gonna get so many things for free or for a reduced price. The first thing I got from Vestiaire Collective were these boots, you guys. Look at this. They're Tommy Hilfiger's. They're such in a good condition. And honestly speaking, I love them to death. And I got them for 50 euros. Can you imagine? Second shoe I got from there are the Gucci loafers. They are in velvet. and they're such a good quality. I keep my shoe trees in them as well. They're such a good quality. They're definitely a little worn, but that has nothing to do with the quality. You can get them for Gucci to get them resold from the bottom, which I'm going to do eventually after a little bit. The two shoes I purchased, but they're still passing. One of them is in quality control right now. It's the Louboutins Riza in 70 millimeter height, 7 centimeter basically. And that's such a classic. I do not like high heels. Like the maximum I would wear is 10 centimeters. Other than that, I think it's like a too cheap looking. In my own opinion, it's not ladylike. Like you would never see ladies wearing anything above 10, I guess. So I bought the other shoes. I don't know what they're called. I think they're the Piego, I don't know how to pronounce it, from Louboutins in the nude, but these are still in transfer, so they did not go to get quality checked. But these also are two shoes I got from there. Oh, by the way, I received my Louboutins. They came in pristine condition. Pristine. I have shoe trees in them, shoe stretchers in them to make them a little bit fit me better, because they're not comfy. But look at this, the soles almost never worn. Another thing I got from there, which is, it looks dirty because I wore it to death and it needs to be washed. I got a Burberry chemise. It definitely looks horrible, but the most beautiful detail about it, and that's what I was looking for, is the hand. The thing is, I went to the Burberry store and I asked for this particular shirt and they didn't have it. They stopped producing them. It seriously is in a horrible condition. It's so dirty. That's a proof that I wore it and it came in pristine condition. I need to wash this thing. I wanted a good looking card holder. I was looking in Ted Baker to buy a new one in sale, and they were like 40 euros, 50 euros, 60 euros. I got this for 60 euros and it's Louis Vuitton. Look at this. And it's the old style they had with it, when you get the cards out and it's like an array of cards. This is so useful because I just don't need to open it and put my hands in and ruin my nails to get the card out. I just like do this, the cards come out. Definitely not that dramatic, but you know what I mean. Also, I've got the trench coat of my dreams. The Burberry coat, it's vintage and it's unisex, so the cut of it is not very form-fitting. When I got this, it was quite big on me, but that's because I'm more on the shorter side and petite side, and this was in a very catchy price. I got this for 140-150 euros, which is exactly the price of new ones from H&M and places like in Zara and so on. So the thing is, I got it tailored. So I went to a tailor here. He's such a good person. I took for him this coat, and also I had my Vivienne Westwood, and when I lost weight, I cried my heart out that I am not able to wear this anymore. He got it tailored for me, and he got this one tailored for me. Another coat I got from Vestiaire Collective, but it's still in transit, is this one by Armani Jeans. I was torn between that Armani Jeans gray one and a beige ecru color, like a light beige color from Moschino, or a light beige color from Max Mara. So these were the three in the same price range. The Armani kind of won first because I was offering a price, and that's the price I got at the end. Vestiaire Collective just became addictive to me. Last but not least, I got myself the Burberry scarf I've always dreamed of. I scored this for 40 euros, which is so cheap. It's 100% cashmere. I saw in the post, the woman said it has a lot of holes in it. Apparently her dog ate at it or something like that. And I honestly speaking felt like, you know what? I'm not gonna get this to drain. I know how to fix it. It's not noticeable except when you get super close. Can you see this? I stitched the holes kind of to hide them completely.
100% wool thread, which costed me €1. And I spent the night stitching the holes. So that is my second hand sustainable luxury haul that I wanted to share, the items that I got from the place with you. I have a huge long wish list, and I made sure that I make a plan where I get paid every month and keep some money for the shopping of my dream capsule closet. Sorry that video was quite long, but I was trying to fit in it so many items. I hope you like it and enjoy it. See you in my next one. Bye.